What's going on, my broskies? My name is Toadski, back again, here to bring you guys yet another One Piece Treasure Cruise video. And today, we are here going to be doing our treasure map preparation video, which was fully announced today. Treasure map Zoro Juro is going to be coming to Global on the, I think it's the 7th or the 8th, one of the two. I actually completely forgot to check the exact date. But in this video today, we are going to be going ahead and breaking down everything you need to know about it. We're going to be talking about the character, and we'll talk about each of the bosses along the way, as well as suggesting some free-to-play teams for you guys, so that you have something to aim towards or something to build and get some knowledge about this treasure map before it begins, so you can get your teams prepped so that when treasure map does actually arrive, you can start playing straight away. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So first thing is first, let's go ahead and start breaking down the treasure map character himself, which is Zoro Juro. Zoro Juro is a strength slash a powerhouse character, so pretty interesting to see that he's not a driven unit. He's actually a powerhouse, which is very good, actually. His stats across the board are actually pretty good. His captain effect, once you fully max limit break him, he's going to boost the attack of strength characters by 3 times, boost their health by 1.1, and then if you use his special ability, you're going to be getting a 3.9 times boost for that one turn only. Now, his sailor effects, which are not listed here, are actually pretty interesting, but one of his sailor effects says that whenever another strength unit uses a special, he reduces his own cooldown by 1 turn, which is pretty good, right? Then we have a look at his special. You can see it starts at 31, maxes at 24. When you limit break it, it goes to 9 turns, and then when you limit break expand it, it'll go to 8 turns, which is very, very good. So the way that it works is it's going to reduce enemies' damage threshold by 2 turns, and then it does a random, or not a random amount, but it does a variable amount of fixed damage to all enemies through defensive effects, and it depends on how many times you've launched the special. So when you first launch it, it does 250,000 fixed damage AoE through barriers. The second time you launch it, it's 500,000 damage AoE through barriers. And then the third time you launch it, it's 1 million fixed damage AoE through barriers. Very, very cool. And then his potential abilities, which are not listed here, are both of the cooldown ones. So one of them being cooldown reduction and the other one being double special activation. Freaking awesome unit. He's gonna make speed clearing just even better. So this is nice to have for sure. He's not gonna be one of those units that's gonna be used to clear high difficulty content, but he's gonna be really nice to use if you need to wave clear content and just get through content easier, especially like really easy content. He's gonna be really good for. So yeah, just a really nice addition to everyone's accounts. So let's start talking about each of these bosses. Now, the Intrusion Battle boss is actually the Zoro Juro character. However, on stage 2, you have to deal with Bonkichi, who is a quick character and has 430,000 HP, and his preemptive attack will have a 98-turn delay immunity, and for 3 turns, he has a percent damage reduction Rainbow Shield, and then also applies 5 turns of Remove SFX, which is the blindness debuff, and then also gives you a full board of Bomb Orbs. So obviously, as you can tell by the picture, Legend Kid is going to be the most optimal character to run as the captain here. And then when you move on to stage 3, which is Zoro Juro himself, again, another quick character with 1.5 million health, and his preemptive has a full debuff immunity, so you can't apply any debuffs to him, which is a bit of a downside there. He does also have other effects where your captains will be binded for 5 turns, and then also applies 5 turns of a 1.1 times chain lock, and then also for 3 turns quick and psi slots are counted as badly matching. So he does a lot of really annoying things, that's for sure. And after turn 3, and then every turn afterwards, he will continuously enrage himself, so that also obviously reduces his cooldown, and it also will buff his own attack. And then below 50%, if he does fall below that threshold, he's going to remove your beneficial effects and blow away 2 of your crewmates. So again, you have to be very careful about his HP, you have to be very cautious of that. So as for the team that I'm suggesting here, I do suggest running Kid as the front captain, because it just generates matching slots a lot easier that way. I would definitely suggest running Kid as your friend captain. But as for the other characters for this fight, if you're running a free-to-play team, Otoko is really nice. She's going to be dropping on the 5th, so make sure to get her done. Her special ability removes damage reduction, really useful to have. Now, Shanks and Ben Beckman on the team, the only reason why he is here is because he actually removes the blindness debuff with his sailor effect, so it's pretty nice to have. Definitely not needed, though. And then we also have Judge, who's going to be really nice for removing the chain debuff that gets applied on the final stage, as well as giving our team a color affinity boost, or a type effect boost. Treasure Map Luffy is another really good unit, because not only will he provide the ability to remove bind for our captains, and also provide an orb boost, but he's also really nice because if we're using Kid as a friend captain, you need need one of those supernova characters to proc his super type special. And then as for the captain spot, I wasn't really too sure what to put there, but essentially any good unit. But remember, I wouldn't suggest putting Luffy there because you do need a unit to remove the bind, and Luffy is that character, so if he is binded, it's obviously not going to work. And I think it's 5 turns of bind, as I mentioned, so with sockets it goes down to 2 turns. So technically speaking, you can still run Luffy as the captain, so long as you have someone like version 1 Rayleigh as a support character to remove the bind. That is something that you could potentially use instead. So now moving on to the next boss against Usohachi. This is the first of the Battle Rush bosses before that final boss. Usohachi is actually an int character. He only has 100,000 HP, so not a lot to really work with there. And he has a preemptive of a delay immunity, and then he does one of either two things. He's going to apply a barrier, but that barrier condition can be one of two things. One of which is a great barrier, for you have to hit 3 greats in order to pierce it. Or it's going to be a 3 Psy slot barrier. And ideally what you want to be doing here is, as we go over to the suggested team, is just running the super type Straw Hats. It does make things a lot easier here because when you run Luffy as the captain and you access his super type special, it generates you all of those Psy orbs that you need. And then obviously because they're all Psy units, they're going to have like huge type advantage. As for the subs here, you don't really need to run anything too specific here. Usohachi does do something below 50%, but he has such little HP that you shouldn't be getting him below 50%. But Luffy obviously is an attack boost. Zoro is an orb booster, Sanji's a chain locker, and then Franky is a color affinity booster or a type effect booster. So with all of these characters plus those matching orbs, no problems whatsoever against Usohachi. The second Battle Rush boss is against Carrot. Carrot is also a quick character, and she has 450,000 HP. Her preemptive has a full debuff immunity. She will also apply 4 turns of attack down to your team, 4 turns of damage reduction on the enemy, so that's 4 turns of a rainbow shield, and then she locks your orbs for a turn and then changes them into badly matching. And then on turn 2, and then every 2 turns afterwards, she'll continuously give you badly matching slots and then cut your health by 30%. And then if Carrot herself is below 50%, she's going to apply 2 turns of paralysis to your crew. So the team that I'm suggesting is, as the picture would suggest, Treasure Map Luffy as the captain is a really good option because he can remove the attack down with his special, as well as giving you the ability to give you an orb boost. So very, very good. Then you've got Otoko, who I'm pretty sure she does change adjacent orbs into matching, so that is pretty cool, of course. But she also reduces the damage reduction. Zoro and Sanji, you can use their switch effect to shuffle slots around, so you can use their switch effect first, then use the Otoko special to give you a higher chance at orbs. And then you've got Judge here as a type effect booster. You could run someone else as an attack booster, but if you are running like full free-to-play units, it is relatively restrictive as to what units you could really bring for all of the fights here. So, you know, you won't see too many crazy teams here, but this team overall should have no problems taking down Carrot. The third Battle Rush boss is against Onami, and she has 550,000 HP. She's also a quick character, and her preemptive will apply 98 turns of defense down immunity, as well as buffing her own defense for 5 turns. So you can't bring any unit that reduces the defense. You actually have to bring a character that states, removed enemies increased defense. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to get through it. But then on top of that, she also applies damage threshold as well, so you do need a unit to remove that. And then on turn 4, and then every 3 turns after that, she's going to continuously recover her health back to full, so definitely kill her before that. And do not get her below 20% because she will apply paralysis and you'll need to bring a separate character for that. So Nami may be a little bit tricky, and I think she has one of the highest HP thresholds of all these mini bosses as well, so yeah, pretty annoying to deal with. As for the team here, the team I'm suggesting is running the brand new Clash Sober Mask that will be arriving very soon on the 5th. He is a 3 times captain to Dex, and his special ability, I think, is adjacent orbs matching, and then it also provides a chain boost. So with this team as well, in tandem with Sober Mask, we're running the Bonnie. Raid Bonnie is so good for this fight because she'll remove both the increased defense and the damage threshold, as well as giving you a full board of recovery orbs, which as a sailor, she also treats as beneficial. So a fantastic addition to the team. And then as for the 2 other units you can see beside her, we've got the Dress Up Fortnite Luffy. His special ability is a 1.5 attack to Strength, Dex, and Quick, so he's a nice addition to the team to get a small attack boost. And then the switch effect of Sakazuki and Isshio can provide a 1.5 times orb boost to Strength, Dex, and Int characters. So not a really ideal scenario, but their switch effect can still provide an orb boost. You got Dress Up Luffy for attack boost, chain boost with Sober Mask. So overall, and again, it has a full board of matching orbs as well. This should be able to get through Onami without too many issues, but I think it definitely in high nav levels, this team is not going to cut it. The final of these mini-bosses is Sobermask. As you can see here, he's Int, and he has 600,000 HP, so he has the highest of the HP of the mini-bosses. Nami's the second highest, and then his preemptive attack has a delay immunity, and then he will apply 3 turns of special bind, but the special bind is only inflicted to your crewmates. So you want a captain that can remove special bind, and as the picture would suggest here, Garp is definitely going to be a good option. And then also, he'll go ahead and apply 3 turns of chain coefficient reduction, and then change your orbs into badly matching. Turn 3, and every 3 turns after that, he's going to paralyze your crew for 3 turns, and then apply additional special bind to your crewmates. And then below 20%, he does a lot of damage, you're likely going to die, so be very careful about that. Now, as for the team, I am suggesting, as I mentioned, Garp is going to be phenomenal, because as I said, he removes the special bind. He also will give you a chain lock, which is great because Sobermask applies chain coefficient reduction, so it works out so well. And then the ambush Sengoku is also phenomenal here, because you get a full board of badly matching slots. If you run a full Sai team, you can use the Sengoku special, you'll get an additional health cut with Garp's health cut, he'll treat the Int orbs as beneficial, and then you'll also get a 2x orb boost. So good. And then we're also running Treasure Map VV as the captain, because she's a great captain, being a Sai captain, of course, and she's also an attack booster. So everything in tandem here works so well. So if you run these 3 characters and then a bunch of Sai characters on your team, no problems whatsoever. If you have your own Legend Garp, it makes it a lot easier as well. So yeah, that's the team that I would suggest against Sobermask. And now we've finally made it to the final boss, which is against Trafalgar Law, but on stage 4, we have to deal with Chopperemon. Chopper here has 430,000 health, and his preemptive attack is going to be a full board of block orbs, and also applies a 5-turn chain coefficient reduction, so definitely a chain locker, or just a unit that can remove the chain coefficient reduction will be really ideal. And then also, when he falls to 0 HP, he's going to cut your crew's health by 70%, which, as you can tell by the picture, running Basil Hawkins as the captain is definitely going to be an ideal option here, as Basil Hawkins loves to get his health damaged, really, so you can get a more output from his special, of course. But moving on to stage 5, which is against Trafalgar Law, he has 1.25 million health, with also being a quick unit. His preemptive attack is 98 turns of a full debuff immunity, so you cannot apply any conditional boost here, which is a bit of a shame. And he'll also apply 3 turns of damage threshold, and then also he will have 3 turns of attack up, so he does more damage to you. And then for 5 turns, he's going to give your crew despair. So you definitely want a despair remover on this fight. But remember, with sockets, it goes down to a 2-turn despair, so you can actually run some type of support effect to remove it if you have something like that on your team. And then on turn 2, and then every turn after that, he's going to give a 99-turn end-of-turn damage, which actually is a 20% health cut, which isn't too bad. And then below 50%, Trafalgar Law will apply 3 turns of a resilience buff, and then below 20%, he is going to do a pretty much a death hit, so you're going to die at that point, so be very careful, of course. And then moving on to the team that I am suggesting, I would suggest to run either Basil Hawkins or Eustace Kidd as the front captain. I think either or will work fine, but it really just comes down to what you feel like running. But either one of those two will be a phenomenal choice. As for the other characters here, Crocodile and Kizaru, Treasure Map Kizaru and then Clash Crocodile, both work very well against the Chopper stage, because Crocodile special, you need to have your captain be Cerebral or Striker, which this Lucci is actually a Cerebral unit, which is awesome. So Crocodile will change the block orbs into matching, and he will give you the base chain boost. So your base chain starts at a 2x, which is obviously really, really good. So it does offset a lot of the chain multiplier reduction, but it doesn't fully offset it, but it's good enough in my opinion. And then also Kizaru, he locks your orbs and then will also give you a 1.75 attack boost for 3 turns. The base chain boost of Crocodile is also for 3 turns. So you can stack these boosts over multiple different stages, which is so good. And then moving into the final stage, you've got the Colosseum King, which is unfortunate that we cannot get his conditional boost here, but we can still use him to remove Despair. And then we've got Doflamingo for a slot boosting effect. And then we've got the brand new Lucci from Pirate Rumble to remove the damage threshold, as well as going ahead and giving the color affinity, which is like, it all works so well. And then obviously the friend captain, either being Hawkins or Kid, can provide additional buffs through their effects as well. So that is my team suggestion against the final boss Law. And then finally, to cap everything off, this is the overview of all of the teams that I've suggested in this video. For Zorajuro, the Intrusion Battle boss, I do suggest running a Friend Captain Eustace Kid, as it'll make it a lot easier to deal a lot of damage towards that Zorajuro boss. And then Otoko and the Treasure Map Luffy. If you do have the version 1 Rayleigh support, you can run Luffy as the captain instead. With the Rayleigh support, that will be a very, very good option. Judge is a fantastic option as well to remove the chain lock, as well as providing a type effect boost. Remember that against stage 2, the Brook will blind you for 5 turns, so having the crewmate effect of the Shanks and Ben Beckman is really nice, but again, not a requirement, but it does make a big difference at the end of the day, allowing you to hit your perfects a little easier. Against Usohachi, the full super type Straw Hat team is going to be more than enough to get through him, no problems at all. Versus Carrot, it's going to be very similar to the versus Zorajuro team, running a lot of the same units with Otoko, Treasure Map Luffy, Judge, all those different Dex characters to give you enough boosts and also the utility to get through the fight as well. Against Onami, a lot of defensive effects, but Raid Bonnie is the key unit there, just removing all of those really annoying defensive buffs. Sober Mask being a Dex captain, Luffy being an attack booster, the swap effect of Sakazuki and Isho being a slot boosting effect all works very well. Versus Sober Mask, I feel like he's also going to be very easy. If you've got Sugo Fest exclusive Garp, it's going to be absolutely no problem, especially if you've got Intrusion Sengoku as well. Just makes a lot of sense, and it just works really well. So having VV attack boost or boost Sengoku, and then Garp for chain lock, removing debuffs, everything just works so well together. And then we've got the Trafalgar Law fight, the final boss fight, which we did just go through just a minute ago, but Friend Captain Hawkins or not Trafalgar Law, but Eustace Kid, either one of those two will work very well as a friend here. Captain Lucci with the subs of Crocodile King, Doflamingo, and Treasure Map Kizaru, all working very, very well to give you enough damage output and the matching slots and the abilities to get around the utility and all the different debuffs to get through the fight. Unfortunately, the multipliers are a lot lower than the previous Treasure Map that we had with Treasure Map Luffy, considering all of the super type units and stuff like that. But despite that, this shouldn't be too difficult of a Treasure Map, so long as you've been maxing out a lot of those free-to-play Dex characters, that's for sure. So that just about does it for this video today. I really hope you guys enjoyed this one, and if you guys did, make sure to go ahead and hit the like button, as these videos do take a very long time to put together. And if you want to stay up to date with all the content that I post on my channel, including more One Piece Treasure Cruise content, make sure to hit the subscribe button down below. But on that, guys, I'll see you guys within the next video.